This video tutorial I will explain how to integrate JPA in Spring Boot application. JPA stands for Java Persistent API. Here you can see database. In this example, we will use MySQL database. And here you can see Spring Boot demo application, which is a microservice application, and it exposes REST endpoint for create the employee record, update the employee record, get the employee record, delete the employee record, and get list of employee records from the database. And in this Spring Boot demo application, we will integrate JPA. Here you can see Postman client. Using Postman client, we can consume the web services which are exposed by Spring Boot demo application. To integrate JPA to the Spring Boot application, what we have to do is, we have to include the dependency of JPA, which is Spring Boot starter data JPA. And using this JPA, we can connect Spring Boot application with relational database efficiently. Spring Data JPA provides complete abstraction over the DAO layer. So we no need to write the implementation for the DAO layer. Spring Data JPA auto-generates the implementation for the DAO layer. Here you can see employee table, and it has two records, and columns are ID, name, age, and salary. Here you can see Spring Boot application with folder structure. Here you can see the pom.xml. Here you can see application.properties file, and here I have defined driver class name, URL of the database, and username and password of the database. Using this information, Spring Boot application connect to the MySQL database. Here I have defined a class employee, and it has four properties: ID, name, age, and salary. And in employee class, I have applied entity annotation, which denote this entity object is for the table employee, and ID is the primary key, so I have applied ID annotation, and also I have applied generated value annotation, so this ID value will be auto incremented while inserting employee record in the employee table. Here I have defined the interface employee repository, which extends CRUD repository, and we are dealing with employee class, and ID type of employee class is integer. If we are using Spring Data JPA, then we no need to write any implementation code to save the record in employee table or update the record in employee table, etc. The Spring Data JPA will automatically generate the implementation for you. Here I have defined the interface employee service, and it has create employee method, update employee method, get employee method, get employees method, delete employee method, and is employee exist method. All these methods are abstract methods. Here I have defined a class employee service simple, which is a service class, which implements employee service interface and provide implementation of all the abstract methods like create employee method, update employee method, etc. Here I have defined a class employee not found exception, which extends runtime exception. Here I have defined the class employee exception controller, and I have applied controller advice annotation. So if any exception occurred in the Spring Boot application, then the exception will be handled by the methods inside this class. And here I have defined the method exception, and I have applied exception handler annotation. So if employee not found exception occurred, this method will take care, and it returns employee not found to the client. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is a REST controller, and it has a create employee method which accept employee object. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post, and this method is responsible for creating an employee record, and it has update employee method which accept ID and employee object. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is put. Here ID is the path variable. This method is responsible to update the employee record in the employee table, and it has get employee method which accept ID. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. And using this method, we can get employee record from the employee table. And it has get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. And using this method, we can get list of employees from the employee table. And it has a delete employee method which accept ID. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is delete. Using this method, we can delete one employee record from the employee table. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Using Postman client, I am sending employee create request to Spring Boot microservice. Here is the URL, and HTTP method is post. In body, we have to choose raw type and JSON format. Here you can see employee object in JSON format. Name is Ram, age is 55, and salary is 70,000. I am sending the request. Here you can see the output. Employee is created successfully with the ID 22. The ID is the primary key. Refresh, and here you can see one record is created. Next, I will send update request. Method should be put, and employee ID we will give it as 22. And change the name. Send the request. Here we got the output, employee is updated successfully. Refresh, and here you can see the employee record is updated successfully. Next, we will send the get request. send the request. Here we got the output. We got employee object in JSON format. Next we will send a delete request. Send. Here we got the output. Employee is deleted successfully. Refresh and you can see the employee record is deleted. Next we will get all the employee records from employee table. Here we got the output and we got the array of employee objects in JSON format. Next, we will try to get the employee record which is not there in the database. Giving ID as 90, send the request. So it throws employee not found exception. The employee not found exception is handled by this exception method and it returns employee not found. And here you can see we got employee not found output. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.